once they lie down all over the Europe, we shall not see them lit again in our lifetime.
It was, of course, the destruction of the great library at Louvain that made many conscious of how the nature of warfare had changed. This wasn't to be one of the little wars of the 18th century. So, its opening piece represented the secular march of the great powers as they engaged in their wishes to criticize a deadly, foolish exercise in science and truth. Or if one wishes to give them the benefit of the doubt, the honouring
breaking of things on
then this
next piece represents the sacred portrayal of what happened.
It is called
the Sweeping of Altars,
which is the name
given to the section of the Monday Thursday vigil,
when
the sacrament is removed from the altar,
and taken
to the chapel of repose,
after which
the congregation disperse without the ceremony.
Often this is
accompanied by a recitation of the 22nd Psalm, number 21 in the World Gate.
And that is
what I will recite now, the stripping of the altars.
Go not for me, for trouble is hard at hand. shall be counted unto the Lord for generation. They shall come, and the heaven shall declare his righteousness unto a people that shall be born, whom the Lord hath made. They part my garments on them, and cast lots upon my bed.
To that women loving and
you. To conclude this performance, we will do two pieces, one short, one not short. The short one is another A. Houseman poem, a recitation to which I have shamelessly cribbed a section from Vaughan Williams's Pastoral Symphony. In the interwar years, the cosmopolitan critics dismissed this piece as simply an exercise in ruralism. They were too blind to realize that it was really a war requiem. To conclude, we have another Kipling setting. This time is Homily on the End of Empire, Recessional, a poem that was performed to the tune Melita at the burial of the unknown soldier in 1920. A performance that was recorded and which we use in the mix. Furthermore, pictures of it begin the visuals of this piece. But in devising Recessional, I realised that it was a movable feast and should be site-specific. So I will be joined by Inez, who will recite the names of the fallen from Louvain, mainly from the initial invasion, but also of some of those that fell later in the war. Obviously, doing something as charged as this requires the accompaniment, both orally and visually, being suitable. For the music, my solution was to hunt down the oldest recordings that I could find of the polyphony of the great Franco-Flemish or Netherlandish school of the 15th century, namely a couple of 78s made by the scholar Polyphonica of Tribulatio et Augustia, accredited on the recording to Josquin, but variously attributed to Philippe Vedelon and Anon, as well as the introit to Pierre Delarue's Sublime Requiem. I realise that his recordings, they aren't contemporaneous with the Great War, but they struck me as the most suitable and fitting. When putting these pieces together at Hunter's studio, in trying to explain the effect that I wanted for the polyphony, I likened it to a weak, early morning sun that slowly appears from behind a mist or clouds. For the visuals, the logistics of finding images of all of the townsfolk would be beyond the scope of this single performance, but I have compiled what I believe is a good cross-section of relevant images to represent the people of Louvain in particular and the Belgian army in general. These are from four sources: documentary photographs of Louvain and its people from newspapers and magazines. Some of these are courtesy of Debrand van Louvain, to whom again my thanks. Contemporaneous family photographs. My thanks to Chartreuse for providing these. Photographs of the Belgian army during the Great War, both formal and in the field. And photographs from the veterans' book, the Golden Book. In using these sources, I realised that many of the visuals will be less focused on just those who perished, but also of those that survived. But I think it is right and proper that we should remember the survivors as well. This aspect, along with the slow revealing of the polyphony, I hope gives this work a positive sense despite its tragic contents. As such, I hope Louvain Recessional can be seen as a song of thanksgiving, even if sung due to the darkest of circumstances. Thank you. Thank you, Vel. Merci. Thank you.
belongs to Fairfield. Our stand agents, living agents, their sub agents, New Zealand's, New Zealand, we stand at the top. Our Lord Shepherd looked at us, and in that context, shall the Lord, our Lord Kami, shall the peace Kami, praise the name Kami, those are for the praying, and the heaviness of me have gathered the remnants, our false might, Pierre Hermann Marteau, Marie Elisabeth Massage, Marie Elisabeth Montez,
Pierre van den Broek, Pierre van den Bakker, Jo
Stoffelijke resten van Corbeek, Loo en Leuven.